Officials in Latvia, a member of the European Union and NATO, have begun to comment on the large-scale corruption scandal involving Latvian citizens. It has to do with the purchase of oil rigs worth hundreds of millions of dollars by the Ukrainian Chornomornaftogaz through a set of offshore companies with dummy directors. Facts that TVI reporters have been talking about for several months have finally become the focus of discussion for senior government officials and politicians at the international level. Latvia's Minister of Economy, Daniel Pavluts, one of the key figures in the newly formed government of the country, is well aware of Ukraine's purchase of an oil rig at twice the price through Latvian dummy directors Vanagels and Gorin. And unlike Ukrainian ministers, responds to these irrefutable facts adequately. I am very ashamed that Latvia is involved in such obvious offshore schemes relative to the first purchase. Our legal institutions will deal with these issues. I've seen this information. This is not the only case where these names have popped up as, like you call them, ZITS directors in various offshore schemes. Indeed, the names of the Latvians Erik Vanagels and Stan Gorin have come up in a number of shady financial scams. Different countries, different deals, different amounts of money that share one thing, an attempt to hide the real owners and launder as much illegal money as possible. So-called grey and black money.
Very black. Drug money from Mexico and the like, or weapons sales from Iran to North Korea and vice versa. It is very black. If we take us and you, Ukrainians, these are more or less corrupt kickbacks.
Я откат не бывает, меня слишком, вот кому-то труба, а кому-то и вышка. Но как-то так ты привыкла, ведь мама страна, тебе ведь не больно.
Working together with TVI, journalists from the Baltic Center for Investigative Journalism have put together a complete dossier on this shadow money laundry through accounts in Latvian banks. Back in summer, exclamation mark journalists found the director of the company Highway Investment Processing, Stan Gorin, in Riga. He is the person whose signature is on the contract to supply Chernomornaftogaz with the rig for $400 million.
You confirm that this is your signature?
Yes, this is my signature.
This signature proves that you are the director of Highway Investment, registered in Cardiff.
I don't know what this company is. My signature could have been copied, transferred, or put there in some other way.
Vanagels and Gorin are just dummies. They don't know that they are Highway Investment processing directors. They don't know that their firms are purchasing something and that their signatures are on these contracts. The events around Highway Investment Processing clearly show that the company is false and the contract is inflated.
This evident and overt corrupt scheme is well known not only in Latvia's Ministry of Economy, but also among the country's diplomats. It's very good that the media have followed this contract with such scrutiny. Our TV journalists, together with their Ukrainian counterparts, covered this issue extensively. There were some questions raised about some secret companies that are registered in some apartments. Then it turned out that they have signed contracts worth hundreds of millions. Such cases must be investigated, absolutely. The great outcry and colossal scale of the Latvia laundry has drawn attention from the local law enforcement officials. As far as I know, information is being collected. We have special agencies that deal with such money flows between banks and so on. This agency eliminates the flow of illegal traffic and money. Let them do their job. Latvian banks are very convenient for money laundering, especially for post-Soviet corrupt officials. Historically, the Latvian banking system is essentially Western, but understands the Eastern mentality. If you look at Latvian banks, then of course, a business is registered in one country, the person is living in another country, his passport is in a third country, and so on. He's doing business in still another country, and the person is banking in a fifth country, the 5 points of shell banking. Just before the results of the journalists' sensational investigations were made public, a large Latvian bank called Kraibank went bankrupt. This event was the main topic in the country. Local journalists don't consider it an accident and believe that the big money washing machine with dirty laundry from Ukrainian oil and gas officials is now a matter for law enforcement agencies.
I don't think this case is closed forever. It's sure to come back, because this is a large-scale issue. And the money that passed through Latvian banks was half grey. And what happens to Kraibanka, it shows that it's bad. You can't take that kind of money out of a bank in one day. It would be a problem for the system, so I don't think this is over. It will continue.
Exclamation mark will closely monitor the development of this international scandal. In our next program, we will describe in detail another super contract to supply a second oil rig to Chornomornaftogaz. For the same $400 million, it was granted to the Latvian company Riga Shipyard, owned by the businessman Vasilis Melniks. Don't miss it.